वेलकम टू ऑल एमएससी पार्ट टू स्टूडेंट. आई एम डीलिंग विथ योर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री कोर्स कोड CHO 351 एज पर 2019 पैटर्न. टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट अबाउट द टॉपिक C13 NMR स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी. दिस इज एन टाइप NMR मीन्स न्यूक्लियर मैग्नेटिक रिजोनेंस स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी. H1 NMR, C13 NMR means proton nuclear magnetism, carbon magnetism. That magnetism observed due to spinning in the nucleus. Nuclear spins are oriented randomly. That is equal to absence of an external magnetic field. Specific rotation is equal to presence of B, that is an external magnetic field B0. Some nuclear spins are aligned parallel to that of the external magnetic field. Some are aligned anti-parallel to that of the external magnetic field as shown in the diagram A and B. Anti-parallel means high energy orientation. What basic principle of the C13 NMR? When energy is given to any organic molecule in the form of radio frequency, then that molecule shows a precessional, shows the equivalent frequency to that of the precessional frequency. Absorption of energy occurs, nucleus start to resonate, and resonating nucleus spinned and gives the NMR signal which is recorded. Nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. Many nuclei exhibit NMR phenomenon. All nuclei with odd number of protons, all nuclei with odd number of neutrons, and nuclei with nuclei with even number of both proton and neutron, that do not exhibit the NMR phenomenon. Just look at the table where magnetic nuclei of H1 NMR, C13 carbon, nitrogen 14, carbon then fluorine 19. All these are magnetic nuclei, where there is non-magnetic nuclei where the both proton number as well as mass number is also the even, that is C12 carbon and oxygen 16. What is the basic requirement for C13 NMR? The proton NMR used to study the number of non-equivalent protons present in the unknown organic compound. Carbon NMR can be used to determine the number of non-equivalent carbon and identify the types of carbon, that will be methyl, methylene, aromatic, carbonyl, methane present in the organic compound. C13 signals are spread over much wider range than the H1 signal, making it easier to identify the count individual nuclei. What are the characteristics of C13 NMR? The chemical shift of the CMR is wider, that is having the delta value ranges from 0 to 220 ppm. With respect to the TMS, that is tetramethylsilane. Whereas in comparison to PMR, the delta value, chemical shift value ranges from 0 to 12 ppm relative to that of the TMS. The Kozy C13 coupling is negligible because of low natural abundance of C13 in compounds. Thus, in one type of C13 spectrum, proton decoupled is magnetically non-equivalent carbon, gives signal, single sharp peak that undergoes further splitting accordingly. Characteristic features of the C13 NMR. The area under the peak of C13 spectrum do not necessary to proportional to the number of carbon responsible for the signal. Therefore, area is not considered in CMR. Proton coupled spectra, signal of each carbon or group magnetically equivalent carbon split by proton bonded directly to that of the carbon as per n plus 1 rule. C30 nucleus is about 1/4 of frequency required to observe the proton resonance. The chemical shift is greater for C13 atom than that of the proton due to direct attachment of the electronegative atom to the C13 carbon. The C13 chemical shift are measured in delta ppm of the carbon with respect to the TMS. The correlation chart is here divided into the sections, that is the saturated carbon atom which appears at a field which is sp3 hybrid delta, lower delta values nearest to that of the TMS. The effect of electronegative atom slightly increase the delta values or chemical shift values lies in 40 to 80 ppm. Alkene or aromatic carbon atom are quite deshielded, that causes the delta value in 100 to 170 ppm. If the compound contains a carbonyl group, that will be either aldehyde, ketone, amide, esters, that will be downfielded, more downfielded, and having the delta value in range of 155 to 200 ppm. The correlation chart is very important because if you look the types of carbon, this is tetramethyl selenide as shown in the diagram, where the delta value is 0 ppm. Alkane is having delta value 8 to 35 that are saturated in sp3 hybridized compounds, that is upfield. If there are two substituted R dash with the alkane, that is gives 15 to 50 ppm value. Trisubstituted gives 20 to 60. Tetrasubstituted alkane gives 30 to 40. Saturated, all these are saturated carbon that are considerably shielded, having the low delta value and therefore upfield. When there is unsaturated carbon, that gives value 65 to 85 for particularly the double bond. Then double bond in aromatic compound, that gives 100 to 150. Aromatic benzene double bonds delta value lies in between 100 to 170. When electronegative atom iodine is substituted with the saturated carbon, that gives delta value 0 to 40. CBr there 25 to 65. Then halogen CCl, that is quite electronegative, hence delta value increases, that is 35 to 80. CN bond 40 to 60. CO bond 50 to 80. CO double bond, that gives the 165 to 175 for amides. Ester is having carbonyl frequency 165 to 175. Then acids having carbonyl frequency 175 to 185. Aldehyde is carbonyl frequency, that is chemical shift value, is 190 to 200. And ketone, the carbonyl chemical shift found to be 205 to 220, as shown in the chart. Then the chemical shift value, if you compare for PMR and CMR, as I told, the PMR ranges from 0 to 12 ppm. 0 is for TMS. Very close to that are the upfield, as shown in diagram. There is 1, 2, that will be upfield. And if you go then onward to the 10, that is called downfield or deep distilled proton. Same is the case for CMR, particularly 0, 20, 40, that side is upfield chemical shift in the CMR. And if you go towards the 200, 220, that side is downfield distilled CMR nuclei, as shown in the diagram. The C13 chemical shift are most affected by hybridization. Here it is sp2 hybridized carbonyl group, as shown in the diagram. Lies in between 150 to 220 delta ppm. That may be aldehydes, that may be ketone, acid, esters, amides, carbonyl compounds, anhydride, yeast, etc. Functional group. That causing deshielding due to the electronegative oxygen atom and sp2 hybridization. As shown in diagram, if you go delta value from 100 to 150, that is because of the olefinic double bond, sp2 hybridized, as well as the aromatic benzene carbon-carbon double bond, either monosubstrate or disubstrate, that would be, but there should be a double bond that is deshielded and come in the range of the 125-128 delta value in ppm. From 50 to 100, that found to be sp hybridized alkyne members, as well as CN bond or CO bond, single bonds. Then 0 to 50 delta value, that are shielded carbons due to sp3 hybridization, saturated carbon. Means in electron, what is the effect of the electronegativity with electronegativity cause the deshielding in CMR spectroscopy? The delta value increases and goes downfield. Hybridization is also play important because the carbonyl compound sp2 hybridized due to heteroatoms oxygen that cause deshielded or values downfield. So we have discussed all these things in details about the chemical shift in the CMR and comparison with that of the PMR. With this, I will stop here. The remaining part we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.